dwell in. Set close to a hill where the branches are telling strange legends of ill. Over timber so cold that they breathe of the dead, crawl the vines so green and cold by strange nourishment fed. Oh, and no man knows the juices they suck from the depths of their dark slimy bed. In the gardens are growing tall blossoms and fair, each pallid bloom is throwing perfume on the air. But the afternoon sun, with its shining red rays, make the picture loom dawn on the curious gaze. And above the sweet scent of the blossoms rise odors of numberless days. Oh, the rank grasses are waving on the terrace and the lawn, dim memories savoring of things that have gone. Oh, the stone of the walls are encrusted and wet, and a strange spirit stalks when the red sun has set. And the soul of the watcher is filled with faint pictures he fain would forget. In the hot June time that I stood by that scene, when the golden rays of noontime beat bright upon the green. But I shivered with cold, groping feebly for a light, as the picture unrolled and my age-spanning size. So the time that I had been there before,